this morning, America has a new idol.
Yeah, wake up, sleepyheads. It was a thriller as usual. Here's how it all went down last night.
Votes of American Idol 2008 is David Cook.
He can't believe it.
Oh, it was a bit of a surprise with David Cook winning, although some of you called it.
Yeah, David Vigiano live in L.A. So what's I called it too, Dave. Me and you.
You
I guess
did?
You. Yes, I did.
Good job, Patrick. 97 million votes, okay?
Woo.
That is a record in Idol history, 23 million more than any other vote in Idol history. And David Cook actually won it by 12 million, which is kind of a landslide. And that happened after Simon on Tuesday night kind of ripped David for all of his performances and saying that David Archuleta knocked him out. So a lot of people thought that David Archuleta was a sure winner. Now, we talked to both Davids after the show last night, and when I talked to David Cook, he said when he was up there waiting for that announcement, he was really prepared to take second place.
I told myself when I walked on stage, I was like, okay, I'm going to take second. So whenever they say Archie's name, I'm just going to turn to the right and congratulate him. And they said my name, and I still heard Archuleta. So words escaped me. It was just an amazing feeling, and I couldn't imagine standing up there with anybody cooler than that kid.
Now, right before that announcement, Simon actually apologized for being a little hard on him, something you never hear Simon do. And David Cook actually said he was really surprised because he took it all in stride and said that Simon's critiques were worthy of his performances. As for David Archuleta, I think he was in a little bit of a shock because he probably went to bed the night before thinking, man, I knocked David Cook out. I'm going to win this thing. But actually, right now, he told us that he's just prepared to move on.
It felt really good today now that everything was just over and so I came, enough of the competition, now we get to do the real music and not be viewed as competitors anymore. And, you know, it's been great.
So, Nancy and Patrick, I got to tell you, after the show, you know, people everywhere here, and we were waiting for David and David to come out,
yeah.
And when they did, all evening long, people are screaming, David, David. I'm constantly looking over my shoulder.
Vigiano?
Like everyone's screaming out my name, yeah. I'm like, no, it's not me. But and David Archuleta, I think, is just having, there's so much. It's just an overload for him. He was having a real hard time concentrating on the interviews because everything's going on around him.
Hey, a lot of people wondering. We're wondering,
yes,
David Archuleta's dad, where was he during all of this finale stuff?
I don't know. I didn't see him once. So I know. I'm sure he was in the audience, but where I was sitting in the back, because I didn't watch the show, I didn't even see any reaction shots of him or anything.
Mm.
So, yeah, I'm sure he was there, but they kept a very low profile. They kept him out of sight for probably obvious reasons. But did you guys check out some of the big-name talent that was there?
Oh, yeah.
Check this out. It was great, starting with Saisha, who got to sing a rockin' duet with Seal. And then Donna Summer, she was in great voice, and she sang with the six female contestants. And Brian Adams sang with the six male contestants. A little odd choice, I thought, here, but Brooke White, actually great for Brooke White, weird for the show, sang with Graham Nash. David Archuleta sang with One Republic. We love that song. And David Cook, who was stoked to sing with ZZ Top. The kids loved the highlight of the evening was, of course, the Jonas Brothers, and who I thought gave the killer performance of the evening, Carrie Underwood. She sounded phenomenal. And then, of course, Jordan Sparks has been rebounding from her vocal problems, and she sounded great last night, too. And we finish off with a big finale with George Michael. And I don't know about what you guys thought, but if you heard his song, I thought that was really strange and kind of inappropriate for the show. It just didn't feel right to me.
Yeah, it kind of slowed everything down. It's ironic that Brian Adams was there, David, because that was my first concert. And Mike Forrest, too, that was his first concert, Brian Adams.
I remember you guys talking about that. Do you have a flashback, Nancy?
Yep, absolutely. And I actually like him more before the concert, though.
Hey, and a little bit of good news. As you know, we've been reporting all season that American Idol ratings have been down about 7-8%. Well, Tuesday night's show up 3% from last year's finale. We haven't got the numbers for last night, which I'm sure are going to be even higher. But it's a really Idol's going out on a high note this season.
All right. That's very good. Okay, Dave, it's only just begun for you. We'll talk to you a little bit later.
Thanks.